Oh God, we pause and bow our heads in the solemn and in the stillness of this hour, in the solitude of your word. God, we come that we may renew the holy bonds of matrimony that these two made years ago. God, we come that their vows may be revived. And we pray and we invite the Holy Spirit to come and be in our midst. God, may He seal this ceremony and this occasion. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Be seated. Dearly beloved, we have Brother Taylor, if you would just stand right here just for a minute. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in the renewing of the holy matrimony and of the vows by which they have made, which is commended of St. Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore it's not by any to be entered into unadvisable or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisable, and in the fear of God. Come in close now and listen to me. Into this holiest state of the renewing, the reviving of the vows between them made, these two come to be joined together in the renewing of their holy vows of matrimony. If any man can show just cause why these two present should not review their vows of matrimony, let him now speak, or forever through eternity hold his peace. Okay, Brother John, Sister Bonnie, listen to me very carefully. Very carefully. I require and charge you both, as you will answer at the dreadful day of judgment, when the secrets of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any impediment why ye may not revive or renew the vows between you that have been made in years gone by, and be joined together and remain joined together in holy matrimony, you do now confess it. You do now confess it, for be ye well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise than as God's word does allow, their marriage is not lawful. Brother John, will thou have this woman to thy wedded wife to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Will thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her so long as you both shall live? Sister Bonnie, will thou have this man to be thy wedded husband to live together after God's orders in the holiest state of matrimony. Will thou obey him, serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as ye both shall live? Who giveth this woman to renew her wedded vows unto this man? Thank you, Brother David. Join your right hands together. Okay, Brother John, repeat after me. I, John, take thee, Bonnie, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hope, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I plight thee my troth. Sister Bunny, as you hold the right hand of Brother John, please repeat after me. I, Bonnie, take thee, John,
to be my wedded husband,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
and to obey, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, according to God's holy
ordinance.
All right. And thereto I give thee my troth. Okay. Release your hands. You have place the ring upon the left hand of Sister Bonnie and hold the ring and repeat after me. As a pledge and in token, of the vows between us which has been renewed, with this ring,
I be wed.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Sister Bonnie, place the ring upon the left hand of Brother John. As you hold that ring, please repeat after me. As a pledge and in token.
As a pledge and in token.
Of the vows between us made.
As the vows between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be renewed my wedding vows. In the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together in the bonds of holy matrimony, and it's these two present, has now come and has renewed the vows between them made years past. That as the power now vested in me as an ordained minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ and by the laws of the state of Georgia, I now pronounce and commend unto you that you have come in the face of this country
and the presence of these people that is now present. And you have renewed your holy bonds of matrimony. So as much as Brother John and Sister Bonnie has consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given and pledged their troth each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, and by joining hands, I now pronounce you man and wife that has come and renewed the vows between them made in days gone by. As you hold that hand and the ring that you just placed upon the hand, I wish I had time to go back in the Greek and tell you what that means. Maybe one day we're there. You know, you've heard ministers say at weddings a ring means a perfect circle. It don't do it. That ring, Brother John, that you placed on her hand, that means everything that you have or ever will have stands behind that ring. When the prodigal son come home and the father put a ring on his hand, that gave that son, that restored him to give him buying power. He could take that ring and go to town and make an involvement on a scroll and buy with it. What you have is hers. What you have is his. God bless you as I pray. Would you please stand for just a moment and let's pray. Heavenly Father, O God, in the name of Jesus, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, O God, we come and we pray that may the Holy Ghost unite and renew the vows that have been solemnly made between these two, and now they have been renewed. God, send renewal, send revival into their hearts and into their homes. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You may kiss the bride. Amen. All right. Okay, y'all be seated for just a moment, if you would. Everybody will be seated. Okay, Brother David.